Roll number 8, are you present? Roll number 8, are you present? So one student is again absent here. Again 44 students I am getting, but 44 I am getting, but oh, now 45. Here, last one. So,
ma'am, I have joined, but I don't know how it.
So, okay, now sorry, ma'am. Still 45 students are here. So, roll number 8, that is absent today for this class. So, only roll number 8 is, and 20 is present. So, again, fill up your Google form after this class.
Ma'am.
For the attendance ma'am, of this
25.
Class.
Ma'am, roll 25 is present.
You were also present in last class though. Roll 25, okay. In this class, only roll number 8 is absent. Other than 8, all of you are present.
Okay, ma'am.
Chanchal Mondol left. It is showing. What is the roll number of Chanchal Mondol? Do you know anyone? Anyone knows about Chanchal Mondol? His roll number?
Fifteen.
Chanchal Mondol is 15. Roll. Okay. Now he left the waiting. Why? I don't know.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. And Shaurav, what is your roll number?
Ma'am, net problem. Ma'am, net problem.
21.
Net problem of Chanchal. Shobha?
Yes, ma'am.
You have net problem?
Yes, yes.
So what is the problem? I am getting your words, what you are saying. You are clearly audible. You are
yes,
audible.
Ma'am.
Hey, Shobhan. So, I have no problem hearing you.
Ma'am, I left next class for some time to net problem.
Last class?
Next, agle class mein, pehle class mein, 10 baje se tha.
So, and if you have problem, then go through it and ask if any question you have after the class.
Yes, ma'am.
Or I will discuss the questions at the starting of my class. If every day, if anyone has any problem, then discuss with me. So probably roll number 15 and roll number 8, both are absent now. 15 entered into the class, now again absent. Class now. Okay. So must fill up your Google form after this class. Again, 45 is showing. Chanchal, are you here?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Roll number 15, you are. Roll number 15, you are.
Yes, ma'am.
Chanchal, roll number 15.
Yes, ma'am.
Your roll is 15. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, okay. Now that I was discussing factor. Chanchal, can you say the expression of quality factor in LCR circuit? Just I discussed.
Yes, ma'am.
Expression of quality factor in LCR circuit. Q equal to what?
मैम आई से
हाँ से
हेलो ओमेगा डेस भाई यार
q = lw
नॉट lw l ओमेगा डैश ओके और lw डैश व्हाटएवर यू कैन से बट एक्चुअली इट विल यू विल से इट बाय ओमेगा सो l ओमेगा डैश बाय r दिस इज द एक्सप्रेशन ऑफ q ओके q इज द ओमेगा डैश दिस इज द डैम्पिंग एंगुलर फ्रीक्वेंसी ओमेगा इज द नेचुरल फ्रीक्वेंसी ओमेगा और ओमेगा जीरो इज द नेचुरल फ्रीक्वेंसी दैट इज 1 बाय रूट ओवर lc ओके नाउ एक्चुअली द डैम्पिंग एंगुलर फ्रीक्वेंसी दैट इज ओमेगा डैश नाउ आई एम कमिंग टू एन एक्सप्रेशन ऑफ क्वालिटी फैक्टर फॉर lcs सर्किट दैट इज l ओमेगा डैश बाय r व्हेन देयर इज नो डैम्पिंग दैट इज अनडैम्प्ड मोशन देन ओमेगा डैश इक्वल टू ओमेगा जीरो मींस 1 बाय रूट ओवर lc So in that case, quality factor is L omega 0 by R. Now quality factor. Defining here, Q of a damped harmonic motion is used to differentiate between light damping and heavy damping. So this quality factor is calculated to differentiate between light damping and If we know the value of Q from there, we can conclude that what type of damping is there. The ratio of the maximum value of the restoring force to the maximum value of the damping force is called quality factor. For less damping, Q is higher. So when small damping or when damping is less, quality factor has higher value. And the quality will be better. For no damping, that is for damping is there is no damping, quality factor that is tends to infinity. That is infinity means here very, very large. Quality factor has large value. But when there is heavy damping or large damping, then Q has lesser value and it tends to zero. So for high damping case, quality factor has very less value and for no damping case you have small damping is when very very small quality factor has larger value so it may be given in MCQ so for large damping case quality factor has which value for large damping case quality factor has very small value and for small damping case quality factor has very large value Am I audible now?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Is the screen visible?
Yes, ma'am.
So quality factor yes, of a damped harmonic motion is used to differentiate between light damping and heavy damping. Now the ratio of the maximum value of restoring force to the maximum value of damping force is called the quality factor. And for higher damping case, quality factor has very less value, and for small damping case, quality factor has very large value. So remember this one: for heavy damping case, quality factor has very less value, and the quality is not better. So when quality factor is higher, the quality will be better. So remember this one. What do you mean by quality factor? And remember also about the expression of quality factor for LCR circuit. This is L omega dash by R. So if LCR values are given, you can calculate what will be omega dash value, and after that you can calculate the value of the quality factor. And the question may be given, the value of the quality factor is very very large for LCR circuit, so what type of damping is there? So damping is very small damping is there. That will be your conclusion. So this thing probably I have given in note. When I have given the note, this one, that is damped vibration, when I supplied this note, with this the value of quality factor is given. So go through it. So this is your PPT 2. This is your second PPT. So go through it. Now, this one. That is introduction to forced vibration. Introduction to forced vibration. Now, till now, I have discussed what is simple harmonic motion, what is undamped motion, what is damped motion. And in damped vibration, there are different cases, heavy damping case, critical damping case, and small damping case. Now I'm coming to this point, that is what is forced vibration. Now, the amplitude of vibration of a damped oscillatory motion of a body with the time due to the loss of energy to overcome the resistive force. You know it. So amplitude divided, if there is oscillation, then the amplitude diminishes exponentially and it execute oscillation for a small damping case. And if there is damping is high, then there is no oscillation, comes to zero, tends to zero at after infinite time without making any oscillation. The amplitude of vibration of damped oscillatory motion, that is amplitude of vibration, it decreases with time. For what? Due to the loss of energy to overcome the resistive force. The force of friction, the different type forces are there. And for LCR circuit, resistance plays the same role. And if R has high value, then heavy damping, R is zero damping case. And it is undamped motion. And for LCR circuit, I have discussed already that R equal to that is omega zero natural frequency of undamped motion, that is equal to 1 by root over LC. If external periodic force is supplied to the system to make up of these losses, the amplitude of vibration does not decrease with time and the body will vibrate regularly under such periodic force. The vibration of the body is known as forced vibration. Actually, you have I have discussed that is in damped vibration, the amplitude decays exponentially with time. So amplitude decays and ultimately it goes to zero. But if it goes to zero, what? Due to the loss of energy to overcome the resistive forces. But if we supply external periodic force to the system, if we supplied some force to the system due to this, due to makeup of these losses, then amplitude does not go to zero value, and the amplitude of vibration, it does not decay with time, and the body vibrates regularly under such periodic force. Vibration is force vibration. So due to the application of external periodic force, the amplitude is not decaying gradually, and the body vibrates regularly under such periodic force. So due to that force, periodic force, amplitude, it is not decaying. So the vibration of the body is known as the force vibration. Okay. So this is the difference between the force vibration and damped vibration. In damped vibration, amplitude of vibration increasing to zero. Amplitude of vibration, but in force vibration, as external periodic force into the system from outside to make up of these losses. Of these losses means loss of energy to overcome the resistive forces. To make up of these losses, the amplitude of vibration does not decay with time. So amplitude, this is the difference. Amplitude of vibration does not decay in time with time in force vibration. But in damped vibration, amplitude of vibration decays with time. So why in force vibration, amplitude of vibration no? Because we are supplying external periodic force to the system to make up these losses. So this is the difference between force vibration and vibration. Tomorrow I will discuss, I will ask the students, what is the difference between damped vibration, force vibration, and the different things that I have discussed in damped vibration and LCS circuit. So in today's, tomorrow's class, first 10 minutes will be question as discussing. Students, you will on your video and you will answer. So you will just taking preparation, you all will come tomorrow in my class. And I want to say that if you are thinking that 10 minutes will be over and you will join, so all the students will come and then I will start discussing questions and answer. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Everyone can.
Yes, ma'am.
So I will ask questions. Tomorrow about today's class. About today's class means about force vibration, whatever I will about force vibration and the full damped vibration, full with LC. I will ask the questions, so be prepared for that, because I have to check you are preparing or not. Go through it and prepare for yourself. Now in force vibration, we have to supply external periodic force. Particle of mass m is subjected to external periodic force. And what is the external periodic force? That I am taking F0 e to the power IPT. Like this, the form is a generalized way. I have written this force, that is F0 e to the power IPT. What is P? P is the cyclic frequency of the periodic force. And so actually in damped vibration, come to this equation. I'm just integrating this. So in this equation, first equation for damped vibration, which one will be zero? Addition in this first equation, which quantity will
F0.
Which one?
F0.
Not F0. F0 e to the power IPT. Say the full term.
Yes, ma'am. Yeah, F0 e power IPT.
So, OK. okay, so this is the equation of force vibration. If it is given, write down the differential equation of force vibration. It is m d2x by dt square equal to minus ax minus b dx dt plus f0 e to the power ipt. So actually, it was initially for damped vibration, the equation was m d2x by dt square plus ax plus b into dx by dt equal to zero. Now, in force vibration, this is the extra term, external periodic force with cyclic frequency p I have taken. Now, this is the term and this is the extra term I have taken. So, this in left-hand side, d2x by dt square plus a by m into ax plus b by m dx dt, this is the all the terms discussed in damped vibration, is it? And yes, actually, ma'am. I have... actually, and here M was there for the calculation. What I have done, I have written M in this side, in right hand side, and I have expressed the first equation like this. This equation I'm again writing as d2x by dt square. This term is same. Then here the change is there. Here it is b by m dx dt. I have written 2k dx by dt because 2k equal to b by m, same as it is in damped vibration. M and in place a by mx, what I have written? In place of a by m into x, what I have
omega
written?
Square. Omega square x.
Omega square.
And omega square equal to a by m. Omega square equal to a by m. Okay. And now, here it is f0 by m into e to the power ipt. So f0 by m, this term is what? Small f. We have considered that capital F0 by m. What is this? This is small f. This is amplitude of driving force per unit mass. So F0 is what? Actually, the periodic force was F0 e to the power ipt. Now we can write it in terms of cos as sine. In some books you may get, if you find any book in library, you may get here sine term or cos term written in terms of that. But I have taken written generally, that is F0 e to the power ipt, e to the power in terms of e to the power, I have represented the external periodic force. So F0, capital F0 is what? Capital actually F0 by m, I have written as small f. Amplitude of driving force per unit mass. So F0 is the amplitude of the driving force and m is divided by m, so per unit mass. So that I'm representing as small f. So small f is amplitude of driving force per unit mass. So let we are considering this. So f0 by m, this is equal to small f. So our this equation just changes to d2x by dt square plus 2k dx by dt plus omega square x equal to small f into e to the power ipt and small f equal to f0 by m. And putting this equation number one, I'm giving this equation number one. Any problem up to this? Yeah. Then can ask. Any problem? If anyone want to ask anything? Have no problem, is it? Are you getting my voice? All of you? Anyone answer?
Okay. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Because yes, ma'am. Maybe net,
yes, ma'am.
Also for me. I'm just telling you from this side and you are not getting my voice. Then how I will understand? If you are not, don't reply. So this is the differential equation for force vibration. D2x by dt square plus 2k into dx by dt plus omega square x equal to small f. I have given it equation number one. This is our task. Can you say? Can anyone say that what is our next similar to that damped vibration? What I will
finding
do?
The value of x. Finding the value of x.
Finding the value of x. So x we will find out. So that means the solution. The solution of the differential equation we have to find out. Okay. So in the next step, solve the differential equation and I will solve it mathematically. Mathematical calculations are there, some. So I will solve it mathematically. Now see, this is second order first degree differential equation. This one. This is second order first degree differential equation. Now I'm going to solve this. So the solution has two parts. First one is particular integral, and the second one is complementary function. We will first solve for particular integral part, and then we will solve it for complementary function. And first, so starting from particular integral. So there are two parts. So we will solve separately, and we will add these two things, and we have the total solution. So for particular integral PI part, let the solution as in the same way, that is x equal to a dash e to the power IPT. So giving it equation number 2. So what is our task now? You can say from here. So what is x equal to we have? So what we will find out from equation 1? From x, d to x by?
Dt square.
Then dx dt, we will put both the values here in this equation. Okay. So next, x equal to this. So we have the value of dx dt. So just differentiate with respect to t. So ip will get here. So e to the power ipt is there. So if you differentiate this thing, a dash as remains as it is, then ip is here, e to the power ipt. Then find out d to x by dt square. Then what we will get? Again, ip will get. So ip square. Then e to the power ipt. And a dash is here. Now, what I'm doing this? I square equal to what?
Minus one.
So I square is minus 1. So have I written this? Minus 1? So minus of a dash p square into e to the power ipt. Minus of a dash p square e to the power ipt. Okay. So this is the expression of d2x by dt square. So from this we have dx dt and d2x by dt square. So what we are doing? Putting in equation 1. Say, you will take one pen and paper. You will find out it. And all the terms are written here. If you put the values, you will get like this. Okay. Just do it after the class. You will get this expression. Already you have the PPT. Probably I have not. I will send you this PPT after my class. So go through it. You will get all the terms. But you will do it yourself. You will start the differential equation for fourth vibration. Then you will take x as this solution. You will find out dx dt on your own. You will find out, and then you will just check you are right or wrong. The dx by dt is here, d2x by dt square here. So all the terms are written like this. Then write a dash. So e to the power ipt. E to the power ipt. So I have not written. This is the common term from both. So I have not written this thing. IPT is here. IPT is here. E to the power IPT. So I'm not writing this thing. So this cancels from both the side. And it remains what? A dash common term. So I have written in left hand side in front of this. So minus of P square. So minus of P square it is written. Here what is remaining? 2K IP. So A dash is outside here. Written outside. And this term is not existing, so cancelling from both sides. I and P. So 2K I and P. What is in this term? Only omega square. So A dash is outside, so only omega square. And in this side, in right hand side, it is only small f. So this is our expression. So A dash into inside the bracket minus P square plus 2K IP plus omega square. Classroom, my task was to solve it in your blackboard, but it is not possible here. I am taking online classes. So I have typed this material for you and typed earlier so that you can understand. Dash into this term equal to F. So after this, any problem? And in mathematics, you will learn all these things, that how to solve the second order differential equation using particular integral and complementary function. I'm not going in detail. I'm just following the steps how to solve. So it is divided in two parts, and first taking the particular integral part. And for that, I have taken the solution x, let this. So I have this expression. After this expression, is it okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Going to the next. So what is a dash? Now from here I have calculated the value of a dash. See, a dash into this equal to f. So what is a dash? F by this thing, bracketed thing. So a dash is small thing. So here, so a dash equal to small f by this omega square minus p square plus I into 2kp. Just written in this way. So actually write it as omega square minus 2k minus p square. It is written like this, omega square minus p square plus I in front, then 2kp. You can write it in this way, omega square minus p square plus I into 2kp. It is written like this. A dash equal to a square minus p square plus I into 2kp. So give it equation number 3. So now what I'm doing, I'm writing omega square minus p square equal to b cos phi and this to b sin phi. So I'm taking, let the assumption like this. So let omega square minus p square equal to b cos phi and this is 2kp equal to b sin phi. Now what is b square? So you can write b square cos square phi equal to what? Omega square minus p square whole square, and b square sin square phi equal to 4k square p square. Now add this two. So b square cos square phi plus b square sin square phi equal to what? Plus p square whole square plus 2kp whole square. So actually from here, as sin cos square phi plus sin square phi equal to 1. So what is the value of b square? Square minus p square whole square plus 4k square p square. So ultimately b is what? B is root over 4k square p square plus omega square minus p square whole square. So putting it as equation number 4. And what is the value of tan phi? Just divide b sin phi by b cos phi. So 2kp by omega square minus p square, is it? So tan phi equal to 2kp by omega square minus p square. So giving it equation number 5. Is it clear?
Yes,
ma'am. So I have equation of s in equation number 3. I have that omega square minus p square cos phi and 2kp equal to b sin phi. From there I have calculated the value of b, that is equal to square p square plus omega square minus p square whole square, root over of this thing, b equal to root over of this thing, equation number 4, and tan phi also I have find out. So this is equation number 5. A dash, what I can write? A dash was what? A dash was small f by this thing. So omega square minus p square equal to what? B cos phi. So here I can write a dash equal to f by what? F by
b cos phi.
A dash equal to b cos phi plus I phi.
B sin phi.
Sin phi.
So this one. A dash equal to f by b cos phi plus I b sin phi. In both the terms, so putting b outside, being outside b, so what remains? Cos phi plus I sin phi. Cos phi plus I sin phi. So a dash, it can be written as equal to small f by b into e to the power I phi. Okay. A dash we can represent it like this. Now what is done? E to the power I phi is in the denominator part. If we write it in the numerator, then what I have to write? E to the power minus I phi, is it?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Power I phi in the denominator, so I have written this e to the power I phi in the numerator, so it is written e to the power minus I phi. Now what remains in the denominator? Only the term what? B. I have written this term in the upper portion. So in denominator term, only b exists, and b already we have. What is b? Our b is this term, root over 4k square p square plus omega square minus p square whole square, root over this term. So substituted the value of b. So given equation number 6. So a dash has value equal to small f into e to the power minus I phi divided by root over square plus omega square minus p square whole square. So whole root of this. So it is equation number 6. Now from equation number 2, what I have? X equal to a dash into to the power I p t. So equation number 2, see, equation number 2, that is x equal to a dash into the power I p t. So x is a dash into to the power I p t. So this is equation number 2. So only I have written this thing. So in from particular integral part, x equal to e to the power x equal to a dash e to the power I p t. Now what I have done? I have substituted the value of a dash. What is the value of a dash? This one. Small f e to the power minus I phi by root over this term. So this is our a dash. Now a dash value I have written here. Small f into this term. So small f into this term, and with this e to the power minus I phi is there. So here in this term, so a dash has this value e to the power I p t is already there. E to the power I p t minus I phi. As a whole, we can write this as e to the power I p t minus phi. So the expression of displacement. So actually, we took the solution as x equal to a dash e to the power I p t. Now after calculation, so in this way, after calculation, initially x was this. After calculation, find out what will be the value of a dash. So after calculating the value of a dash, we have put it here in this equation, and finally we have the expression of x. So finally, the expression of x is a dash e to the power I p t. So a dash value I have from equation 6. So from from equation 6, the value of a dash I have substituted here in this equation, and ultimately the displacement is given by x equal to small f by root of 4 k square p square plus omega square minus p square whole square. With that, that's e to the power I p t there. Now from a dash e to the power minus phi I am getting. So combining these two, that is e to the power I p t into e to the power minus I phi, that is e to the power I p t minus phi. So this is the displacement. I can write it this way. So what is the amplitude? The first part amplitude. So what is the amplitude part? Amplitude, it is written like this. Small f by root over this term. Root over this term means 4 k square p plus omega square minus square. So it's the amplitude term. So this is our equation 8. So integral part, we took the solution like this. X equal to a dash e to the power I p t. We have find out the expression of a, and we have substituted the value in equation number 2. Substituted the value, and ultimately the amplitude, expression of amplitude that we have as equation number 8. So this is our expression. Now for complementary function, so we have two parts. The solution is divided into is but for the particular part, and another is for, so for the particular integral, the solution is equation 7. So for particular integral, the solution is equation 7. So x is like this. Now I'm coming to the next complementary function by putting the right hand side of equation 1 equal to 0. So what is our equation 1? So equation 1. So how complementary the right side of equation 1 equal to 0. So what is the equation? Remains as, if the right hand side becomes 0, what is the equation?
Damped vibration.
So that plus 2k into dx by dx where x equal to 1, then this equation. Now, when the damping constant k is small, this equation is damped oscillatory motion. That is, you said that it is the damped oscillatory motion, and also solution of this. If it is damped oscillatory motion, the solution is what? that it is damped oscillatory. Oscillatory is so this is only the oscillatory. You know, function of to into power minus kt sine of omega dash t plus delta. Is it known to you, this expression?
Yes, ma'am.
So the solution of damped function, and this is the equation of depression, and the solution like this for oscillatory motion. Damping case or critical damping for oscillatory case, this is the solution. X equal to sin 2 to the power minus kt sine of omega dash t plus delta. So giving it equation number 10. And here omega dash I have taken that root over omega square minus k square, because omega here omega dash it is written like this. So this is the equation 10 is the solution for the complementary function. And for particular integral, what is the solution? Equation 7 is the solution. Equation is 7 is the solution for particular integral. And equation 10 is the solution for complementary function. So the total solution is the sum of these two. So x equal to this term plus this term. Term due to forced vibration, this term. Term vanishes, then totally damped vibration. So in the total, the equation is this, C plus 2k dt plus omega square x equal to f small f into e to the power I pt. What is the solution as a whole? This is for complementary function solution, and the total solution x equal to this equation number 11. So this is the total solution. So the first part of the solution represents the damped simple harmonic motion. So you can see first part of the solution, it represents the damped simple harmonic motion, and after a few time the vibration becomes negligible as its amplitude diminishes exponentially with time. And this is the damped vibration, and you can see the amplitude diminishes exponentially with time, and as a whole displacement will go to zero. After a lapse of time, the second part, that means this part of equation 11, that is steady state term, represents the forced sustained oscillation. So this second part, it represents the forced sustained oscillation whose frequency of oscillation is p by 2 pi will be the frequency of the applied force. So this term exists later, that is the forced vibration term, and after some time this will be diminished with time, because the amplitude diminishes exponentially with time. Second part, this is very important, represent the force sustained oscillation whose frequency here p, that is p by 2 pi will be the frequency of the applied force. So with the frequency of the applied force, it will be forced sustained oscillation, and the solution of the forced vibration, it is given. So the solution of the forced vibration, what is the solution? X equal to this term. So after some time, after as a whole this is the solution, but after some time the first term will be diminished with time, because after a time vibration will be negligible, at least amplitude diminishes exponentially with time. So amplitude goes to zero after some time. So what term will remain in the solution? X equal to what? Anyone? X equal to what? X equal to only the second part, it exists. After some time, the second part only exists. And the solution, I can write it as this, X equal to F by root over 4K square P square plus omega square minus P square whole square to the power I P T minus. So this is our equation number 12. First part, it is written, the first term, this is the amplitude part, and frequency is P by 2 pi. And what is phase? Phase equal to tan inverse 2kp by omega square minus p square. So this is the phase of oscillation, this is the frequency of oscillation, this is the amplitude of oscillation. So this is the solution for forced vibration. Understand? The physical solutions can be extracted from the complex solution by taking the real and imaginary part. Because I have taken e to the power I pt minus pi, you can write cos pt minus pi or sin pt minus pi. So this is the real and imaginary. That means physical solution can be extracted from the complex solution by taking its real and imaginary part. So you can see it here. If I take the sine part, then x, it can be written like this, f by root over this thing into sine pt minus phi. Then small f equal to this, small x equal to this, x by dt equal to this, that is velocity is this. So in the steady state solution condition, the velocity of the driven oscillator at an instant of time leads displacement by 90 degrees. Explain it tomorrow again, because I am going very pretty complicated. What you have to remember, this is the force vibration term, x equal to this. This is the solution for force vibration. As a whole, if we solve the equation, you will get two terms. But after some time, this part will be go to zero, and the second part exists. And second part is the part solution for the force vibration with amplitude this, with frequency this, and with phase this. Okay, student, I'm not discussing, it is already 12 and you have next class. So I'm ending my class here. Tomorrow you will prepare all these things, damped vibration and forced vibration, including today's class. All of you.
Please.
And you will answer in
share the notes.
What? But you will do your job. You will do what you have to do. You have to read it. I will send it. Okay. So now ending my class.
Okay, thank you.
Okay.